everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today, it's sunny. We can't even believe it's sunny. It's been so dark and cloudy and rainy for a month. This is spring. This is spring to us, and it may last just one day because then we get a little colder and then it gets warmer and then it gets... Anyway, so we're taking advantage of it, and today we are going to be trimming and propagating Montauk daisies. Now, if you look at this mess right here and you say, yuck, what in the heck is that? These were our beautiful white blooming Montauk daisies. They bloom one of the very last weeks of fall, and then they go until it freezes, and then they're done for the season. Then you come out in the spring and you see this and you're thinking, what in the heck is going on here? So we know that from the past, we know that they have to be trimmed back. And if they aren't trimmed back, they get very unruly and disgusting looking.
Well, spindly.
And spindly,
so
right.
So we're, taking about 12 inches above the ground level?
So, yeah, let me just go down here.
Are you going to take that one all the way down?
Well, I suppose I could stop here. And you can see that it's green and living right there. And up at the top, you're thinking, okay, not impressed. Well, I can take this out of here. Then I can trim this off. I can chop this off. And here we have a beautiful stem that is ready to stick into the ground and start a new plant. It's amazing how that happens. In the past, I've tried trimming them and putting them in water, as you've probably heard me say multiple times. And then I realized that I can just put them in the ground and they will become a new plant.
Oh, they root very quickly when you put them directly in the soil.
Yes. And we have a bird that is scolding us because her nest is right over there and she thinks we're bothering her. Anything?
Not that I can see yet, but she definitely has left a mess.
Yeah, well, they always do, but then they make little babies.
So this is really the babies from another plant.
Our original bush.
And then all of those back here.
Right.
In buckets.
We did the same thing to propagate all of those buckets full. Now we took 3 and 4 inch pieces of
cuttings.
Montauk daisies, yeah. Like this much. Put them into 4 inch little pots, probably about 4 or 5 in each little pot, and sunk them in the ground and just left them for a season, right?
1 year, yeah.
Right. And then last spring, we came out, dug those pots up out of the ground, put them into these bigger containers.
I put 4 pots, sometimes 5, depending on, you know, the number
right.
of cuttings
no.
into each one. If you go all the way down to the end one, I started trimming that one.
So which would you rather have? This or that?
Well, I know which one I want.
So this for this year, this will be wonderful. We don't need to take any big, there aren't any huge ones that we need to take out and actually root this year. These will be just beautiful the way they are. But they won't look beautiful until we've trimmed them. This started out as a cutting. I think it was just one cutting.
This was the actual original plant that every other Montauk daisy you see
came
on our property came from.
Yes, so maybe this was in a pot when we bought it at Montauk Farms. And for 3 years, 2 or 3 years, we haven't done anything with it because we've just been so busy doing other things. So this was the year. These stems were at least this tall. And of course they were flapped over and they look just like those horrible ones over there where they're all ratty and scraggly. And so what we did is we took off the amount we wanted to, and then we cleaned them up. Now when we plant these in the ground, I'll just knock off these two and stick them right into the pot, and this will start a brand new plant.
Well, it's also important to remember where the bottom is,
well, yes.
How you cut it.
Yes, you have to remember, because you don't want to be sticking this end in. And you can usually tell because the bottom is usually wider, but also all of the leaves are going upward. So be careful when you're doing that. Like, here's a good example. Let me see, which end was it?
That one you could probably cut in half.
I probably could cut it right there and have two plants coming out of this
one.
Go
ahead and do it.
Alrighty, I shall.
I'll hold on to this for you.
Thanks. There you go. Two of them. Woohoo.
Double
the trouble.
Double or nothing, right?
So these are going to be going in different places around the yard. We'll just be Montauk daisy.
You'll have a forest of daisies.
Just like right now we have a forest of daffodils. They're just everywhere. But they won't last. And Montauk daisies will stay green all summer. And then in the fall they get this beautiful, perfect daisy. They're in the chrysanthemum family, and they are tough. They live in this climate. They're tough. They even live in salty areas. Montauk, New York, I believe it is where they got their name. And
well, it's definitely an East Coast area that they came from.
Right.
I tell you, once you have one plant, that's all you need, one plant. And you may have to do some hunting to find it, because our viewers have told us they're having trouble finding them, let alone, you know.
It's hard ordering them. Maybe it's better this year. Who knows?
Well, if you get there early, I would think you have a better chance than waiting till midsummer or summer. I mean, it's like any other plant that's in favor. The early bird gets the worm.
That's right. Occasionally, if you get too carried away, you'll actually pull one out of the ground that already has a root. Woohoo! Head start. We're using a garden soil, but we've also put in a lot of perlite. Those are white specks that you see, and that will help keep the pots and the soil soft and not turn
moist.
As hard as a rock.
Well, it retains water.
Yes, but it also adds airspace.
Right.
So your oxygen can get to the plants.
And you don't have to pack this in very heavily.
No, you don't want to pack it too hard, because when you push your stems in, you don't want them to break. All right, now, like I said, you just take your branch, make sure you've got the up going up. Now, this one's hard to tell, but I think it's this way.
Yep, I think so, too.
Okay, so I'm going to take this little guy off.
Yep.
And then how many do you want?
I'd say about six in each one.
Really?
Maybe seven.
Really?
Well, at least five.
Four.
No, I think it has to be at least five. Feng shui. I always go with odd numbers.
Feng shui.
I like to have fun.
Ooh, look at this one. This is a bonus one. He's going to go in one all by himself over here. And we'll add people with him. Well, not people.
A twofer.
I do want to press the soil around it so they don't all just fall over. But also so it has soil contact. And if you feel like you need to add more soil, then that's the time to do it. That one might be a little low.
Well, this one definitely is too
low. Yes. It's looking like a Montauk daisy forest over here. I'm putting five and six and sometimes seven stalks in each pot, making sure they're settled in. But if they're tiny ones like this, there's plenty of room for them. I just want to make sure they all get settled in there. And then these will stay outside all summer, and come fall we'll probably plant them in the pots in the ground like we did the last time.
Mm-hmm. I think so.
And then in the spring, we will be putting them in their new homes right into the ground. Now, when you look at a pot like this, we're not going to take them apart. We'll plant the whole container in one spot, so it's a whole little plant.
Just to protect them for the winter.
The whole pot will be emptied, and this whole grouping will be planted together.
Well, you have a root cluster in there that's just like any other plant that you take out.
Correct. So we continue on. There's still more that have to be trimmed and cut and put in.
Yeah. A little pile over there.
Yes, I do.
I think you're going to need more pots.
I think I am too.
I think that's upside down, isn't it?
I don't know.
Yes.
Yep. Yep, you're right. Good you're standing here.
Well, sometimes when you're cutting, they accidentally get put in upside down.
They do.
Also, I found some really shorties.
Yes, you did. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with these guys.
Well, they can go in a pot by themselves. Like that. Actually, those are probably the size you planted last time, because they were just little 3 to 4 inch stems.
Right, and then you have something like this, which is its whole little
thing.
I'm
going to
cut. Well, I'm going to cut this off and plant the whole.
Oh, the whole thing.
Clump together. Yeah, I've done that a couple of times. Okay, so I'll just stick it right in. Just make sure it gets down far enough so that there's some.
Support.
Nodules that hit the ground where they need to form roots. Okay. Shorties going in shorter pots. We've run out of big pots, so we'll just be very, very full.
These pots are maybe 4 inches tall.
Yes.
Yeah.
4 by 4.
I mean, you literally could take any of these longer ones, cut it in half. I mean, they will grow.
Yes. It's already a clump.
Well, why don't you do this? Why don't you cut that off right below there, and that way it'll get all of these in the ground for you.
Yeah. In you go. Oh, look. No leaves whatsoever on it, but if you look at the stem itself, there's still green, there's green. So as an experiment, Rick wants me to plant just this one.
Right in there.
Okay, here we go. Grow well. Now they all need watering.
So when you water your trees, if you need to.
I don't think I need to.
I don't think you will, but if you do.
It's going to be raining tonight and tomorrow, but we will water these in right now, just so that we know that the soil is getting in contact with the stem itself. Well, we don't know exactly how many we have done, but there's a lot here, and many of them will take root and start new plants. That's our goal. Will they all do it? Probably not, but the majority will. If you enjoyed this video and maybe learned something that will be helpful in your garden, please give us a thumbs up. We'd really appreciate that. And if you'd like to see some of our other garden videos, please go to wisconsingarden.com. Also, if you would like to become part of our garden family, there's a little button right over here that you can click on that will allow you to subscribe to us. And also, if you want to know when a new video comes out and you are subscribed, there's that little bell up there at the top that'll give you an announcement that a new video is back.
Well, you actually have to click on it to activate it.
Yes.
You know, we're looking for water lilies.
We are looking for
and
water
lilies. And if anybody is in our area here and you know where some water lilies are, we would love to know about them. Pretty soon. I mean, this now is the 5th of May?
May.
Is it May 5th or May 4th?
No, I think 3rd,
May the 4th be with you.
The 4th, that's it. May the 4th be with you too.
And happy Mother's Day on Sunday.
Yes, happy Mother's Day to everyone. So if you do know where water lilies are for sale, or if you have some that you don't mind sharing, please let me know at lynn@wisconsingarden.com. Thank you very much. Enjoy your weekend, and hopefully enjoy spring finally in Wisconsin.
Connect with us on YouTube.